Hi, I'm Jen Lowe with General Designs, and I'm going to show you how to do an origami folded box. Start with two-sided paper. It doesn't matter which side is up, and we're going to fold it in half. And you can simply do a finger crease. You need to use paper that is fairly thin, cardstock, so that it can fold without creasing. Okay, this is a mountain fold, this is the peak, and this is a valley fold. So I'm going to put this valley side up, turn it around, and we're going to make a second fold. And then we'll put this so both the peaks are up, put your finger in the center and press down, bring it over on the angle, and make a diagonal fold. Then you're going to take that so the peaks on the diagonal are up, press your finger down in the middle, bring the two tips to the center, and you have kind of like a little basket going here. Just lay that down on the side and press the top down. And this is a basic napkin fold. And you can see it looks just like a little paper napkin here. What I want to do is there's a jointed tip on one end and then a loose floppy tip on the other end. Put the jointed tip towards you. We're going to fold it in half. It doesn't matter which side you bring over because we're just making a crease line. You can see this paper is a little bit too thick. I'd probably prefer something a little thinner. Okay, we're going to start at the top, and we're going to bring this down on the center line here and fold that in. And we're going to do the same thing on the other side. And I call this a graduation cap. I don't know why it looks like a graduation cap to me. We're going to flip it over. We're going to do the same thing. Bring the tip, the corner in on that center line crease that we made there. Press it down. And then bring the other side in. And now I say this looks like a kite to me, so we're calling that the kite fold. Once again, take that tip that's closed, bring that towards you, stick your finger down in the crease, and we're going to open this out, line this crease up with the fold inside there, and press flat, and you want to do that on each side. Sometimes you need to stick your finger down all the way in there if it's a tight fold in there, a tight joint. Okay, then we're going to flip it over, and we're going to do the same thing to the folds on this side. So you have a little octagon shaped pattern going on here. Lay that back down, and we're going to fold this over now here. And you've got a crease line here. You're just going to fold it back inside on each side. So you're going to do a reverse fold here. And then you should be able to just go one flap over and two flaps over and have the same design again with those creases in here. And we're going to fold that down again. Bring those in. And now we're going to take that top tip. It'll be loose. We're going to bring it down as far as it will, matching the center line on the center line. Fold that flap over one. Bring this tip down. Same way. Just press that. Fold it over. Bring it down, flip the whole thing over, bring that tip down, and fold one more back over, so that you have two on each side. And this kind of looks like a diamond. I call this a diamond fold. Once again, that jointed tip is on the bottom. Just place that on your table, and then gently stick your fingers down inside, and we're going to shape this into a box as we open it out. And with stiffer paper like I'm using now, it's going to be a little bit harder, but just work your fingers in there and get that crease to come down. And there you can see we have a little box. Once again, the reason for using two-sided paper is so that it doesn't matter which side is top or bottom. But you can also just use regular one-sided paper and then put some ink or, you know, paint on the other side of the paper, or you can use white if you like. There are several things you can do from this point forward. You can simply fold, you know, do a little finger crease along the edges here and bring the tabs over. I just put a little tape on the bottom and make a little square box. I kind of like the polka dotted. This was chatterbox paper here that I used. You can, let me get this box back up here. You can take this and you can bring the flaps up and bring two down and make a basket. And so I've got a little basket design going here that I've already taped together. So that's kind of cute to put a little holiday gift in, anything you like. You can take a dowel, a wood rod, and you can wrap it around the tips and just finger curl, and it will stay. So you can curl up Or you can take and wrap it down and curl down. And these boxes like this require no tape at all. So here's what I've done where I've curled the tips up. I've got a little box going like that. And then here's one that I've curled the tips down. I kind of call these jester boxes. The fun thing is that they will also stack on top of each other, and you can do fun things with the tips that way. Now, this is made using a 12-inch square of paper, and this one's made using an 8-inch square of paper, so you can see the difference in the sizes in the boxes, and you can start playing around with different size paper. Anything will work, just as long as you use a square piece of paper. Then you can also use different kinds of paper. So that was just regular scrapbook paper. This is Michael Murray fabric paper. And so this was about a 5-inch square, and I've made a little box here. And actually, I didn't take my tape off yet. I put little dots of glossy accents on the bottom to hold the fabric together, and just taped it until the glossy accents dry. So we'll go ahead and grab the tape off of here real quick-like. And you can see now that my bottom stuck together with no tape on that. And I have a tiny little box that measures about 2 inches across, started with a 4-inch piece of paper. So once again, you can do all different kinds of sizes here. This box is less than 4 inches, and what I've done here is I put fantasy film on the back and the front of a piece of paper, and then folded that into a box, and it just heats up the edges just a little bit so that it zaps it. But I thought that would make it kind of a little cute ornament to hang on a tree. Believe it or not, once again, here we go with some stacking boxes. You can do fun little things with them. You can make a lid for your box if you want. This is the smallest I've ever done, and this was done with art clay silver paper type. And this is a paper type clay that when you fire it in a kiln or with a torch, the binder burns away and it becomes 0.999 fine silver. I put a little rhinestone in the center of this. But this little box measures 1/2 inch across, and you can see from my fingers it is tiny. But I'm just going to loop a chain right through that tip there. And then I've got a little pendant that I can wear, a little necklace. So that came out really cute, and it is hard as sterling silver. It's just fine silver after it's been fired in the kiln. So that was a fun little thing to do. Finally then, I started this all because I was doing demos for Mr. Ellie Poo, and that's Carl Wald, and he makes paper from elephant dung. Yes, it's elephant poop. So here I've done just a plain little box and taped it together. But the fun thing of doing this is that if you're demoing and you have a little 10-year-old boy come up and you tell him to make the box out of poop paper and then go home and put some M&Ms in it and serve it to his the kids in his class and tell them that they're serving, they're eating out of poop. It'll get a big kick out of anybody. So again, just a fun little holiday thing that you can do with your kids, or you can make these as little gift boxes and give away and just enjoy. Thanks.